His stroke took him down at the height of his power. But Sharon's legacy lives on in Israel, for better and for worse. Older generations remember him as the brilliant and daring general with the swagger, hero of the desert and Israel's three major wars from 1948 to 1973. But he also became a symbol of Israel's occupation of Lebanon in 1982. And as prime minister in 2005, he led a deeply divisive campaign to uproot thousands of Jewish residents of the Gaza Strip. It was done in the name of peace, but Sharon missed the years of rocket attacks on Israel and that Hamas takeover of Gaza that followed the pullout. Sharon believed Jews had a right to visit their holiest site on Jerusalem's Temple Mount. But when he went there in 2000, the Palestinians launched a second violent uprising, or Intifada. Israelis elected him prime minister just a few months later.
He was the last prime minister that actually fought in our war of independence when Israel regained its independence and sovereignty back in 1948.
Sharon was one of modern Israel's most popular prime ministers. His battlefield exploits earned him the name the Bulldozer. Sharon began his career as a fighter in the Haganah, the Jewish underground army, and he fought in Israel's 1948 War of Independence. In the 1967 Six-Day War, his lightning moves against Egypt and the Sinai helped Israel triple the territory it controlled almost overnight. In 1973, with Israel in desperate straits after it was attacked on the holy day of Yom Kippur, Sharon's bold maneuver trapped the Egyptian Third Army and turned the tide of the war. But in Israel's next war, Lebanon in 1982, Sharon was disgraced. Many blamed him for failing to prevent a massacre of Palestinians in the Sabra and Shatila refugee camps. He resigned as defense minister, but stayed in the mainstream of Israeli political life. He also helped mastermind the Jewish settlement building in Judea, Samaria, and the Gaza Strip, seizing on their strategic value.
All those communities that we build in Judea, Samaria, Gaza District, the Golan Heights, they are not obstacle to peace. They are obstacle to war.
His legacy will be of great leadership. He was very, very proud of his Jewishness. He was very proud of Jewish history. He felt the responsibility for the Jewish people and the Jewish history and the reconnection of the Jews to their land.
His commitment to the settlements was so strong that many Israelis were stunned when Sharon proposed and then completed his controversial plan to evacuate Jews from the Gaza Strip. As the leader known as Arik is laid to rest, Israel is surrounded by unstable enemies on nearly every side. But the Jewish state is stronger than ever, and millions of Israelis know that is due, in some measure, to Ariel Sharon.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.